Welcome back to my channel. So before I start painting my face, I'm just applying a light layer of foundation and my brows. Then I'm popping in these eye contacts. I think these are just from eBay, just beforehand because I know my eyes get really watery and I didn't want to ruin my makeup. Then using this Morphe 35C palette, just applying this bright orange eyeshadow. I didn't put an eye primer down just because I was going to be applying a lot more products to my eye and I just thought it was an unnecessary step. So I'm just packing this shadow onto my lid. Then using Black Track from MAC, I am just creating a really harsh cut crease. You don't have to be too clean with this because we're going to be painting upwards. So if you do feel like you need to make a mess, it's kind of better to make the mess upwards rather than onto the lid. But yeah, just creating that cut crease look. Then I am just creating a wing shape, extending it from the lower lash line and then creating a thick kind of line on my top lash line, just like I would with a normal winged eyeliner, but just making it a bit thicker than normal and then just connecting that to the cut crease. Now for the slightly tricky part, I'm creating the kind of triangular eye design. So I'm just painting upwards from the line that I created from the cut crease and then connecting it down towards the wing. I think it's kind of easy if you just watch what I do rather than me try and explain, but then once I was happy with the shape, I just filled it in. Taking this white face paint from the Snazaroo kind of, I think it's just a face paint set. I really should have done this beforehand, so just a tip before I would do the white bit, just kind of creating that white skin effect that clowns have. Using another cosmetic sponge, just applying the white face paint underneath the eyes like you would if you were just doing a really strong highlighting look. Taking this gel liner pencil from IT Cosmetics, I'm just really roughly lining my waterline. Taking the matte black shade from the same 35C palette on a large shader brush, I'm just buffing this underneath my eyes kind of messily to create a scarier look. I decided to take this bright purpley pink shade, but you can pick any colours you want. Where I've placed colour, you can obviously replace them with whatever you want. I'm just buffing out the black that I just placed down. Time for the lower triangular design. I'm just taking the black face paint from the Snazaroo set and, as you can see, just taking a small eyeliner brush and doing one from the inner corner, the middle and the outer corner in like a thin triangular shape. And just painting little dots on the end of them all. Then added two red dots on the top of the top triangles. And then painted a bigger black circle on my nose. If you're not confident with going straight in with paint, then I recommend going in with a black pencil first. Onto the lips, I'm taking this lip pencil from MAC in the shade Cherry and just outlining my lips as normal. For a scary clown, I definitely recommend red. This ties in with the red dots that we created, or maybe even black, but as you'll see, I do a little mix of both. Filling my lips, I'm using the new Anastasia Beverly Hills liquid lipstick in the shade Candy Apple. Using the black face paint and a thin eyeliner brush, I'm using it to extend my smile in like a creepy upwards motion. Then use the paint to line my lower lip and my top lip a bit harsher. Then just blending that in to create an ombre look. Then taking the Kat Von D shade and light palette and the grey contour shade, I'm really harshly contouring my cheeks. Then I'm just applying a light coat of mascara. I'm not going to be wearing false eyelashes, shock, just because I don't really think it suits the clown theme, and I'm not applying any to my lower lash line either, just because you can't even see my lashes, so I didn't really think there was any point. Then for my neck, I am just painting that pinstripe look with the white and red face paints. You could just leave it there, but I wanted to make it extra creepy, so I'm going in with this gel blood and just kind of dripping it down from places that I thought would make it look creepy, so like the mouth and the red dots that we painted on earlier, and then kind of creating a tear look, because I'm pretty sure there's something about clowns being sad and I thought that was quite creepy, so I kind of made it look like a blood tear. But just have fun, it's Halloween, and just place it wherever you want. But other than that, that's the finished look. So that's the finished look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. It was the last of my Halloween one, so the videos after this will be back to normal. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and if you've recreated it, make sure to hashtag my name and tag me on Instagram. But until then, I'll see you soon. Bye!